Marvel films haven't been regarded incredibly well the past few years. Ever since Endgame came out, people have kind of slowly been tuning more and more out of keeping up to date with them, and this might be for good reason. A lot of people say that the MCU isn't as good as it used to be, it doesn't feel like it's building towards anything, and a lot of the films now kind of serve no purpose. And I would argue it's kind of always been like this. Not to that full extent, but to say that there's films that come out nowadays by them that have no relation to anything and are just kind of filler is a bit of a statement I don't really agree with. They've always had stuff coming out that didn't really serve anything and just kind of exists to sell a product. However, this year they took a step back. We're what, 6 months into the year? And they've only just released their first film of 2024. And this is probably the most ambitious thing they've made in quite a long time. This being Deadpool and Wolverine. The first time they've ever actually done anything with these Fox characters. I say that, they've definitely done cameos and shit before, but this is the first time they've done an actual full-on project, making it stand on its own. Now, this is probably going to end up being the highest grossing film of the year. I can imagine everyone's going to go and watch it. But the question is it actually any good? Is Marvel returning back to form? Or is this just another dud in their roster of new films that doesn't work whatsoever? Here's some context before I get people commenting, oh, you're just a Marvel hater, you were gonna hate this from the start. None of that's true. Deadpool 1 was actually the first film I ever snuck into when I was underage. I went with my dad. We both thoroughly enjoyed it. We went to go see the second one. I still hold these films to pretty high regards. The second one, not so much, but I still enjoy it. I don't hate it. And the same goes for Wolverine. I rewatched a lot of those X-Men films. I watched some of them for the first time this past week, and there's some of them that work very well and some of them that don't. Logan, to me, is the magnum opus of these Fox universe characters. It is such a great film, and I couldn't recommend it more than enough. But let's talk about Deadpool and Wolverine, and how it compares in comparison to these Fox films and these MCU films. I'm gonna list some things that I like. It's always great to see Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, puts it in his all, and as much as he wants to try and get away from playing this character, I don't think he ever will, and he will always be remembered for this more than anything. Some of the action is pretty great. There's this one specific scene in a car. I loved it. And surely it had other things that I liked about it. I guess not. Okay, well, sorry. Is this the film that the MCU needs to come back? Does it leave an ever-growing impact on the state of the rest of their films? It does not whatsoever. The story follows Deadpool as his universe is at stake of collapsing. So he must team up with another Wolverine, not the one from Logan, thankfully, and save it. This is a clusterfuck of a film, and it puts fan service and nostalgia baiting in front of any real story or comedy or anything that could be written smartly. Now again, before I get into any real criticism, I like all the people involved in this. Sean Levy's made great films in the past, Ryan Reynolds has done something good, I'm sure, and I love Hugh Jackman. This is just a mess though. I don't know what they were thinking. The story kind of goes nowhere, especially that last hour. It feels like a lot more, it feels much longer than 1 hour. It just goes on and on and on, and it's really disappointing because I really wanted to go into this and like it, but I just knew that what we were going to get was a soulless movie that would rather make its fans feel a little bit better than provide them with any actual in-depth story or emotional stakes. It reminds me a lot of that Multiverses of Madness, the Doctor Strange movie that came out a couple years ago, and a lot of people complained because they thought it was going to be full of the cameos and stuff, and sure enough it had, well, it had Krasinski in it just for him to get axed off earlier on, but there's nothing there. And I'm sure there is some fans of Marvel that will go into this and love it, and that's completely fine, but for me it's just not what I was looking for. Another big issue I have is the music throughout. It reminded me a lot of the Mario Bros. Movie, somehow, where a lot of the music being chosen to be played is only being played because it's somewhat popular and people will recognize it and they'll walk out and go, oh, I like the soundtrack. But it's like, it doesn't actually push the film anywhere. It's only done for choices of this is popular, so we'll stick it in there and people will like it. There's also so much music. I swear every scene has about 2 different fucking songs, and it's like, push your story with actual dialogue and good scenes and not just music to try and get things to go places. I don't want to spoil this film either, so I'm not going to address the cameos, but If you've seen my film about Ghosted, you know how I feel about cameos, especially ones that are just done to be like, oh, I know the actor, I recognize him, I'm enjoying this because I recognize this person, and stuff that's actually done in a smart way, so I'm just not going to spoil them. The sets look great, you can tell which bits are shot on actual locations and which bits aren't, and it's like, that's perfect. You have some of these scenes where the saturation on the camera is just completely fucking not there. And it's like, well, what did you gain from doing it on an actual location? Because it doesn't look good. You have this great set, specifically this set in the void, which has that big crushed 20th Century Fox logo. And it's like, that would have looked great if you could actually properly set your saturation for these shots. Just like the I think at the end of the day, people are going to see these movies, and that's completely fine, but people will also continue to complain about how they aren't what they used to be. And to that I say, maybe you should start voting with your wallets. And I'm no better, because I still went to go and watch this as well, but if you really have a problem with them, stop going to see these films. And I think, for me, that's what I'm going to start doing, because I'm turning into a little bitch over these movies. So yeah, the big question, does Deadpool change the trajectory of where the MCU is going to go next? Not really. It just feels like another filler bit of nothingness that contributes to getting people in their seats, and it will probably make $1 billion, but at the end of the day, it prioritizes nostalgia over actual in-depth story. And if you're sick of this, just stop going to fucking see him. It's as simple as that, which is what I should be saying to myself. Thanks for watching this one. This is such a fun little video, isn't it? I sound like such a whiny little brat, but I don't care, this is just how I feel about this stuff. I don't know what I expected, and yeah, I'm still disappointed, so yeah. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, share, subscribe. If you hated it, please comment down below and let me know that, because I'm sure some people will for this video. So yeah, thanks for watching, and yeah, see ya.